Welcome back to Derivatives and Risk Education. This is lesson 5 of our Derivatives Foundations course. In the last couple of lessons, we've built a solid understanding of futures markets. Today, we're tackling a really practical challenge in hedging, cross hedging. Think about airlines. One of their biggest costs is jet fuel. Fluctuating jet fuel prices can seriously impact their profitability. Ideally, they'd love to hedge this risk using jet fuel futures. But here's the catch. Actively traded jet fuel futures contracts are not always available or might not be very liquid. So, what do they do? This is where cross hedging comes in. Instead of hedging with a perfect instrument, they use futures on a related asset. A very common strategy is to use crude oil futures to hedge jet fuel price risk. Crude oil is refined into jet fuel, so their prices are related, but they aren't the same thing. Today we'll explore what cross hedging is, why it introduces a new type of risk called basis risk, and most importantly, how to minimize that risk using the minimum variance hedge ratio. I won't just give you the formula, I'll explain the intuition, we'll see where the formula actually comes from, and we'll look at an example with real data. So, let's define cross-hedging formally. Cross-hedging is a hedging strategy where you use futures contracts on one asset to hedge the price risk of a different but related asset. In our airline example, jet fuel is the asset we want to hedge, and crude oil futures are the hedging instrument. Why do we do this? Well, sometimes the perfect hedge simply doesn't exist, or isn't liquid enough to be practical. Crude oil futures markets are usually liquid, making them a good alternative. However, using a related asset introduces basis risk. Basis risk, in the context of hedging, is the risk that the price of the asset you're hedging and the price of the hedging instrument will not move in a perfectly correlated way. This imperfect correlation means that your hedge might not fully offset the risk you're trying to reduce. This is particularly important in cross-hedging, where you intentionally use a hedging instrument that is different from the underlying asset. Basis risk is the unavoidable cost of cross-hedging. A call then becomes, how do we minimize this basis risk? That leads us to the minimum variance hedge ratio, MVHR. This is the tool we use to minimize basis risk in cross-hedging. It tells us the optimal number of futures contracts to use for each unit of the asset we're hedging. It's not a naive one-to-one hedge, it's a carefully calculated ratio. The MVHR formula is this, H equals rho times sigma S over sigma F. Let's break this down. H is our hedge ratio. This is what we want to calculate. Rho is the correlation coefficient. This measures how strongly the spot price of jet fuel and the crude oil futures price move together. Correlation of plus 1 means they move perfectly in sync. 0 means no linear relationship, and negative 1 means they move perfectly in opposite directions. For effective hedging, we want a positive correlation, closer to 1 the better. Sigma S is a standard deviation of spot price changes. It measures the volatility of jet fuel price changes. Sigma F is the standard deviation of futures price changes. This measures the volatility of crude oil futures price changes. Intuitively, what does this formula tell us? Correlation matters. The higher the correlation, rho, the more effective our hedge can be. If jet fuel and crude oil prices are highly correlated, the hedge ratio will be closer to 1. The volatility ratio, sigma S over sigma F, adjusts for relative price swings. If jet fuel prices are more volatile than crude oil futures, sigma S is greater than sigma F, then the ratio is greater than 1. Then we need to use more crude oil futures to hedge each unit of jet fuel, because jet fuel prices are swinging around more. Conversely, if crude oil futures are more volatile, sigma F greater than sigma S, the ratio is less than 1, and we use less than a 1-to-1 hedge. You might think this sounds sensible, but why this formula? Where does it come from? The answer lies in linear regression. MVHR isn't just pulled out of thin air, it's statistically derived to minimize variance. Think back to basic linear regression. We're trying to find the best fitting line to describe the relationship between two variables. The basic equation is y equals alpha plus beta times x plus epsilon. Here y is the dependent variable, x is the independent variable, beta is the slope coefficient, tells us how much y changes for one unit change in x. Alpha is the intercept, which is the value of y when x is equal to 0. Epsilon is the error term. In a hedging context, we want to predict changes in the spot price of jet fuel, delta S, based on changes in the price of crude oil futures, delta F. So our regression becomes delta S equals alpha plus beta times delta F plus epsilon. So here, delta S is our y and delta F is our x. Now, when we run a linear regression using historical data, jet fuel spot price changes and crude oil futures price changes, The beta coefficient that we get from the regression is actually our minimum variance hedge ratio. Linear regression works by finding the line that minimizes the sum of squared errors. Essentially, it's minimizing the variance of the errors around the line. In hedging terms, minimizing the error in our regression is directly related to minimizing the variance of our hedge position, and therefore minimizing basis risk. Let's make this practical. How do we actually calculate and use the MVHR? In the description to the video, there's a link to a Google Sheets file where you can see all the details of the calculations, which I will talk about in the next few minutes. I'm using Google Sheets as I think this will allow anyone to access it without needing Excel. Now, if you want, you can download the file and use it in Excel or whatever is your favorite spreadsheet app. So, step one, data collection. We need historical price data for both jet fuel spot prices and crude oil futures prices. I gather daily data for 6 months from September 2024 to February 2025. The spot jet fuel prices are from the US Energy Information Administration, EIA, and the crude oil futures prices are from the St. Louis Fed. There are links to the data in the spreadsheet. In the Google Sheets file, the price data is in the data tab in columns B and C. Step 2, calculate the price changes. For each day, we find the difference in price from the previous day. We use percentage changes rather than just the differences. This will be more robust and economically meaningful. And here's a scatter plot of the price changes. This shows that there does indeed seem to be a relationship between spot changes and futures price changes. That is pretty close to a straight line. This graph is in the spreadsheet in the graph tab. Now, in step 3, we calculate the MVHR. First, we'll do this the long way. I'll show a quicker way in a minute. Now that we have the percentage change data, we can calculate the inputs to the formula for MVHR. In the calculations tab, I use the correlation function on the price changes to get the correlation rho. We see that we get 0.8082 for the correlation, so pretty close to 1, which is good. This shows the prices move quite closely together. We use standard dev to get sigma s and sigma f, standard deviations of the jet fuel spot price and the crude oil futures price respectively. We get 2.10% and 1.98%, but the volatilities are very close, which is another good sign that this could be a good hedge. So we get for the minimum variance hedge ratio a value of 0.8575. As I mentioned, this is the long way. We saw earlier that in the linear regression, the value for beta is actually the MVHR. So to show that this does indeed give the exact same result, we can use the linest function on the percentage changes to get the MVHR in one step. The value is identical, which shows the two methods give the same result. So you can just use linest directly in Google Sheets or Excel. There's no need to calculate the rho and sigmas, though it does help with intuition, I think. Then finally, step 4, applying the hedge ratio. Imagine an airline needs to hedge 1 million gallons of jet fuel. One crude oil futures contract is for 1,000 barrels of crude oil, which roughly corresponds to, say, 42,000 gallons of jet fuel equivalent. I should point out that this is a simplified example. The actual conversion is more complex. So, then to hedge 1 million gallons of jet fuel using a naive 1-to-1 hedge, you might think you need to sell around 24 crude oil futures contracts. 1 million gallons of jet fuel divided by 42,000 gallons per contract, which gives 23.8. But using our MVHR of 0.8575, we adjust this. Adjusted hedge ratio equals the 0.8575 times the 23.8 contracts, which equals 20.4 contracts. So we'd likely sell around 20 crude oil futures contracts instead of 24. This lower number reflects the fact that crude oil prices are not a perfect proxy for jet fuel, and we're minimizing the variance, not aiming for a perfect one-to-one offset. It's crucial to understand that the MVHR isn't a perfect solution. It has limitations. Historical data reliance. MVHR is based on past data. Correlation and volatility we calculate from history might not perfectly hold in the future, as market dynamics can change. Non-stationarity. The relationship between jet fuel and crude oil prices isn't always constant. Model risk. Linear regression is a simplification. True relationship between spot and futures prices might be more complex than a simple linear one. Despite these limitations, MVHR is a significant improvement over naive hedging, cross-hedging scenarios. It provides a statistically sound way to minimize basis risk, making your hedges more effective. So, in this lesson we've learned about cross-hedging, unavoidable basis risk it introduces, and how the minimum variance hedge ratio derived from linear regression helps us minimize that risk. Use an airline and crude oil future example to see how this works in practice. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss upcoming lessons. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions about cross-hedging or the MVHR. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.